Coming up, I will introduce you to Multi-Geo Capabilities in Office 365, now generally available. And if you haven't looked at Multi-Geo since the preview, I will point out some updates along the way. If you are a multinational organization, Multi-Geo in Office 365 is designed to help you to control where your data resides at a per-user level, based on your global data location and compliance needs. It means that you no longer need to stand up SharePoint, mail, and file servers on premises in specific regions around the world, and you can comfortably move to the cloud, pinpointing where each user and their data will reside geographically. Equally, if you are already in the cloud, you can flexibly move users and their data across the geos, all within a single global tenant, and set policies for security and compliance at a global or regional level. For your users, this also means less information silos. Because everything is in a single tenant, your users get a unified set of experiences from file sharing to unified search and easy access from mobile devices as well. Let me start by showing you how easy it is to extend your Office 365 tenant to multiple data locations in two simple steps. Here we are setting up Multi-Geo for OneDrive. As you can see in this global map, you can choose your satellite data locations from the list of supported geos. A geolocation can be a region or a country. And we are continually extending our coverage as we expand our data center footprint for Office 365. If you would like more detail on our data center locations, you can learn more at the link shown and drill down into the actual data center locations. Here, I will choose Asia Pacific. And if I scroll, you will see these four services are available. Now let's dive into adding a satellite geo to your tenant. Let's say your tenant is currently located in North America, which is abbreviated to NAM, and you want your tenant to be extended to Japan to meet your data residency needs there. You select the Manage Locations option in the OneDrive Admin Center, and then select the desired satellite data locations that you want to add, in this case, Japan. Next, in the domain name field, I have chosen our company name with the suffix of the satellite location, Contoso Energy JPN. This will be the URL namespace for my new geo. ContosoEnergyJPN.SharePoint.com will be the root URL, and ContosoEnergyJPN-my.SharePoint.com will be URL for OneDrives. Note that each geo has a unique URL. Unique URLs per geo allow you to immediately know which geo a specific user's OneDrive or where a group site is located. This is going to take some time, and the satellite session will be set up soon. Now, if down the line you want to add additional satellite geos, just run the same wizard, select your geo, it's that simple. Equally, we will make a wizard experience available if you decide that you want to remove a geolocation. To show you that we have been successful in adding Japan as a location, if we go to our OneDrive Admin Center, you will see that our tenant includes Japan among the list of locations. Next, let me show you how to assign users to the new location in Japan. Whether these are new or existing users, you will want to set the following attribute, preferred data location, with the set MSOL user commanded. Here I am adding Noyoki to the Japan location. And to validate that Noyoki is assigned to Japan, you can run get MSOL user commandlet, and I have added a second pipe with display name and preferred data location, and this will return Naoki's display name and his current location, which is successfully set to Japan. The last thing I will do is to enumerate the groups of users and their locations that we will be seeing throughout this demonstration. Given that many of you will have large volumes of user accounts synchronizing from on-premises directory, you can also use the familiar Azure Active Directory Connect tool to set this preferred data location value. You can learn more about Azure Active Directory Connect tool at the link below. For new users like Noyoki, once you set the preferred location property to Japan, their Exchange mailbox and OneDrive will be set up in Japan. Now, for users with existing OneDrives, there is one additional step. You can use the SharePoint PowerShell module with the new commandlet start SPO user and content move to move the user's OneDrive to new geolocation. Here, for example, we only need the user's user principal name and the location that we want to move them to. By the way, all multi-geo activities by admins are logged and audited for future review as well. With multi-geo setup, users in satellite locations now can get the same rich experiences as users in your central location. The experience for them is seamless, while you have full control over where their data resides. Last time on Microsoft Mechanics, I showed you the unified search and content discovery experience for satellite users. Let me now show you how we have made productivity experiences like Shared With Me view in OneDrive and Free Busy Calendar in Outlook seamless across devices. Let me first show you the Shared With Me experience in OneDrive on the desktop. Here I am logged in as Melissa, an European satellite user. I have got all my OneDrive files, and I can see all the files shared with me by my colleagues from around the world. I can see the Free Busy Calendar experience for the international colleagues that I work within my time zone from Amsterdam, and I can schedule a meeting with them no matter where they are located. These experiences extend to other apps in Office 365 that use OneDrive, SharePoint, and Exchange at the foundation. And if I am on the go, the same great experience is available, not just in my browser, but I can enjoy rich mobile apps experiences by simply signing in with my email address, from searching for content, sites, and setting up meetings with my colleagues from around the world. As you saw, users don't need to remember the site or OneDrive URLs or mail server names to access their resources. It just works. And as an admin, you can also apply site-specific policies to protect users and their information. For example, you can configure a site-specific policy to limit access from unmanaged devices. Here I have picked a specific site used by the legal team in Europe, and I want to check the conditional access policy. When I run it, I will see Allow Limited Access, which allows full access to managed devices and limited access to unmanaged devices. Now, as Melissa, when I browse to the same European legal site from an unmanaged device, like a kiosk or my personal computer, I am informed that my experience is limited with no option to download, print, and sync from this device. So this leads to the last thing that I want to show you, the admin management experience. Let me show you what the management experience is like for a multi-geo tenant. Each geo will have its own URL, as you can see here indicated by APC for Asia Pacific. Each geo also has its own OneDrive admin center, which we are in now, and a SharePoint admin center. This way, you can manage the OneDrives and sites in that particular geo. As a global admin, multi-geo satellite user licenses are managed from the single Office 365 admin portal. Equally, you can configure data loss prevention policies tailored for specific OneDrives or sites through the Security and Compliance Center. For example, here is the US Financial Data Loss Prevention Policy, configured for specific users and specific sites in Central North America location. Lastly, eDiscovery Manager roles can also be configured, defined by geo, through the Security and Compliance Center. So that was a quick introduction inclusive of the latest updates to multi-geo capabilities in Office 365. Exchange and OneDrive Multi-Geo is generally available now. To learn more, check out the link below and contact your Microsoft account team. Thanks for watching.